Hell in a Cell. Brock Lesnar returns. Becky Lynch is the new SmackDown Live Women's Champion. And Jeff Hardy tries to kill himself. And much more. So this is my Hell in a Cell review, and we are starting right now. So the show started with the kickoff show between New Day and the Rusev Day. And this was a pretty good match. It was better than your normal pre-show matches because New Day was involved in it. And at one point people thought that Rusev Day might win, but they lost the match because of their ongoing storyline of heel turn. And it was a pretty good match. As expected, New Day won, and I predicted New Day too. And this was the kickoff match, the only kickoff match, and this was pretty good match. On the Monstar star ratings, I will give it a 3.25 stars. So yeah, next up we move on to the main show, and this is where Hell Risen. So yeah, we got ourselves the Hell in a Cell match between Jeff Hardy and Randy Orton, and the color of the cell is red. It's red blood cell. Haha, I passed the joke, so you should laugh at it. So yeah, it was a brutal match. It was a very brutal match. And Randy Orton put a screwdriver through Jeff's earlobe, which was disgusting to watch. And Jeff Hardy killed himself because, as I said in the prediction video, that Jeff is going to do some crazy shit from inside the cell, and he did it. He just hung up on the cell from inside and just threw himself on Randy and went through a table. And it was a missed opportunity to hit an RKO on Jeff, but yeah, Randy is a heel, so he couldn't get a pop from the crowd. Yeah, Randy moved aside and Jeff Hardy hit himself face first into the table, and yeah, that was the end of the match. This match was pretty good. Yes, sometimes the cell was not needed in this match because it was basically them doing Extreme Rules match inside a Hell in a Cell. But yeah, at last the cell came into play, and it was a pretty good match. It was a very, very good match actually. So the show was going on pretty good right now, and there was also a beautiful looking Godbuster that Randy hit on Jeff between the two ladder legs, which was beautiful, and it was also brutal. So yeah, and Randy Orton was bleeding from his back because Jeff Hardy hit multiple chair shots on him, and also Randy was also busted open his thighs. And yeah, so this was pretty good match. I will give it a 3.75 stars at the Monstar ratings. So next up we got ourselves the match for the SmackDown Live Women's Championship between Becky Lynch and Charlotte Flair. The story being that Becky Lynch is the unused one, Becky Lynch is underutilized one, and Charlotte Flair has been handed everything on a gold bladder. So yeah, and Becky Lynch finally won. It was a pretty good match, and Becky Lynch finally won. It was a very pleasant ending because nearly everyone from casuals to hardcore fans to kids to everyone wanted Becky Lynch to win. And yes, finally the moment has come true, and the ultimate underdog has won her second SmackDown Live Women's Championship. It was a pretty good match. The encounters were very good when Charlotte tried to hit the spear, but Becky Lynch turned that into a cradle for the win. It was a very surprise finish, and it was also very good. At last, Charlotte was in the ring, and she came there to congratulate Becky. Becky Lynch thought she was trying to steal her spotlight again, which I think she was trying to. And then Becky Lynch just raised her title and went away, and Charlotte was in the ring alone, crying and sobbing. So next up we got ourselves the match of the night between wait a minute. So the Monstar star ratings, I will give Becky Lynch versus Charlotte a 3.5 stars. And next up we got ourselves the match of the night between for the Raw Tag Team Championship between Drew McIntyre and Dolph Ziggler versus Death, Seth Rollins and Dean Ambrose. It was a fantastic match from start to the end, and thank God Dolph and Drew are the champion finally, because this is what they can do when they are champions, unlike the B team, fuck off. So yeah, this was a very good match, very, very good match, maybe the best main roster match in 2018, best pay-per-view main roster match in 2018, because I think Gauntlet match was better. This was absolutely fantastic match. I think the match that can be above this is maybe the Shinsuke versus AJ last man standing match, which I personally loved. I know many people don't love this match as much, but I personally love that match. But this match, this was absolutely fantastic. I have to look at it again, because that's how I will analyze that it is that good or not. But it was fantastic match, absolutely loved it from start to the end. So yeah, at last Drew hit the claymore on Seth Rollins for the win. Absolutely fantastic near falls, fantastic pace, fantastic storytelling, fantastic in-ring psychology. Everything was in this match. Dolph and Seth were amazing this match. Drew was also very good. Ambrose was also good, but this was absolutely fantastic match. I will give it a 4.5 stars in the Monster ratings. It was that damn good. So yeah, next up we got ourselves the WWE Championship match between AJ Styles and Samoa Joe. So yeah, WWE Championship match still didn't main event the pay-per-view, and it was like 3 matches away from the main event. So yeah, what can we do? But AJ Styles retained the title via cradle, because there are too many cradle finishes in this pay-per-view. I mean, there are two, but there it looked like there are many. So it was, the match itself was fantastic. It went for like 20 minutes and it was absolutely fun of a match. And but there was another screwy finish for AJ Styles match, and there have been like 10 to 12 screwy finishes for AJ Styles matches till when he is WWE champion or United States champion, which is kind of a shame, because AJ is such a great performer. You don't need screwy finish for his matches. He's already here, such a great performer. He could give us a great match. And Samoa Joe got screwed. Why? Because Samoa Joe had AJ in the hold and AJ was tapping out, but the ref didn't saw it, and then at last AJ cradled Joe for the win. And yeah, at last Joe argued with AJ and AJ just hit him and went away. So yeah, then Samoa Joe met with Paige, and Paige says that the decision is final, but they are going to meet at Super Showdown show for the championship match, and I think it is going to be a no DQ and no count out match, which will be very good, because their two matches are pretty good. So yeah, next up we got ourselves a match which is the worst match of the night. The pay-per-view so far has been going so good. I thought this pay-per-view will be the one of the best pay-per-views of all time, but then the mixed tag match happened and it was okay. But yeah, Brian and Miz, and they put minimum efforts for Maryse and Brie Bella, which was good. But yeah, this match was not that good, and I personally didn't enjoy it. The heels won when Maryse cradled Brie Bella, again a cradle. So yeah, it was okay match, nothing special about it. Yes, the heels want to continue stirring the storyline, because Daniel Bryan and Miz are going to face each other for the number one contendership for the WWE Championship at Super Showdown. So yeah, this was okay stuff, and I personally didn't enjoy it that much. This was, yeah, the storyline continues now because the heels won, and yes, I will give it a 2.25 star in the Monster ratings. I will give AJ Styles versus Samoa Joe 4.25 star in the Monster ratings. I personally love that match. Next up, we got ourselves a match for the Raw Women's Championship between Ronda Rousey and Alexa Bliss. This again was not that good of a match. Ronda was selling too much in this match because of her ribs. The storyline was that Alexa Bliss has injured Ronda Rousey's ribs on the previous Raw episode. So now Ronda Rousey was selling their ribs, because only that's how Alexa Bliss is believable against Ronda Rousey. But at last, Ronda Rousey beat Alexa Bliss in the match, and it was okay. I mean, it was nothing special, but yeah, Ronda Rousey is very good. Her facial expressions, her offense, her selling, her defense, her everything is pretty good. She's an all-out wrestler now. She can. I'm ready for Ronda Rousey versus Charlotte Flair match at WrestleMania, which will be a very good match. So yeah, this was a very, very good,
okay match. I was saying very, very good match because I'm stupid. This was an okay match. Nothing special. The pay-per-view was going on pretty good until the mixed tag match. But this was okay stuff. Then we go. I will give it a 2.5 star ratings in the Monster rating system. And so finally, we got a Hell in a Cell match again. Again, the Red Cell is coming down for Braun Strowman versus Roman Reigns. It's the big dog versus the monster among men. So yeah, and Mick Foley is the special guest referee. So yeah, this match continued with the Roman Reigns starting to hit Braun Strowman, but then Braun Strowman taking the control, and this match was going good until there was shenanigans involved. Drew McIntyre and Dolph Ziggler came in, and then Seth Rollins and Dean Ambrose came in. They all went up the cell, and Braun Strowman and Roman Reigns were just lying under the cell like lifeless bodies. And then yes, Drew McIntyre and Dean Ambrose just took each other out via clothesline on the top of the cell. But then Dolph Ziggler and Seth Rollins both went through announce tables, yeah, which was okay. But then what happened was, I personally enjoyed it, some people didn't, because this man was hated for a long time, quite a few weeks ago, and he's back again. Brock Lesnar returned, and yes, he just kicked the door off, and it was amazing. And then he just, like a kind gentleman, put the door in, and then he F5'd Roman Reigns from Braun Strowman. And the F5 was so brutal that they have to double count out the Hell in a Cell match, because yeah, the F5 is the most brutal thing ever. Because when Mick Foley fall off the cell two times against The Undertaker, he didn't, he continued the match. But these both can continue the match because F5 is so devastating. So yeah, this was a shitty ending to a pay-per-view. Although Brock returned in a Viking beard, which looked badass. But this was a shitty ending to a overall pretty good pay-per-view. So I will give Hell in a Cell a 7 out of 10, which is pretty good considering main roster pay-per-views. It is the best pay-per-view of the year. Main roster pay-per-view of the year. So yeah, Hell in a Cell was okay. The ending was shit, and the mixed match tag match was shit. Other than, it was great stuff. I will give Roman Reigns vs Braun Strowman match a 2.5 star match, because I was enjoying the match in the early half, because yeah, Roman Reigns is pretty good in weapons offensive matches, and Braun Strowman is pretty good in them too. But yeah, the ending was shit, which leaves a sour taste in my mouth. So yeah, this was a good pay-per-view, and I personally enjoyed Hell in a Cell. So yeah, let's see what Super Showdown brings to us, and Evolution brings to us, and Saudi Show brings to us, because they have to continue to promote 3 pay-per-views again. So yeah guys, this was my Hell in a Cell 2018 review. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Thank you guys, and have a nice day.